Hello, with Annette here. Welcome to another of videos of my stories about movie production gone wrong. This production proves there was no such thing as fire resistance. The Warrens of Virginia. Directed by Elmer Clifton, this silent drama was distributed by the Fox Corporation in 1924. This story is about two childhood friends, Agatha Warren, played by Martha Mansfield, and Ned Burton, played by Wilfred Lytell, who became really close throughout school, to the point they became lovers. The Civil War began in America, which drove the couple apart, as Ned fought for the Union and Agatha's family fought for the Confederates. After the war was over, Ned decided to meet up with Agatha once again, although Ned was forced to carry a fake note by a Union general. Because of the note being discovered, Ned was classed as a spy, which led him to be hanged. Luckily for the production team, most of Martha's scenes had been completed. As while the movie was in production in San Antonio, Texas, Martha's costume caught fire due to a cast member not discarding a match properly. Martha's chauffeur burnt his hands as he tried to get her out of the burning dress. Wilfred placed his heavy overcoat on her. When the flames were finally extinguished, Martha's face and neck were saved from the flames. However, due to the amount of burns she had sustained from the blaze, Martha unluckily died in hospital the next day. This movie is not about steel on wheels, it is about having your head in the clouds. Hell's Angels. Directed by Howard Hughes, the war movie is based on the First World War, and it contains a story about two brothers who flew for the British Royal Flying Corps. These brothers were not similar in any way. This movie was earlier filmed to be silent, but as the production was still in motion 18 months later after filming began, the era of sound in movies was already in full swing, making this 1931 of the firsts with sound. Greta Nesson, who was a Norwegian-American actor, was assigned the leading role of Helen for this silent production. When sound came into it, Greta was replaced by Jean Harlow, because the director did not like the sound of Greta's voice. This movie was mainly black and white, however, with scenes that were a dramatic effect needed, like the scene similar to the Hindenburg disaster, color was used. Harry Parry was a pilot who worked closely alongside Howard Hughes to plot the dogfights. Due to Harry classing the final scene as highly dangerous, Howard decided to fly the plane himself. As Howard was performing the stunt, the plane crashed, which caused Howard to suffer a fractured skull, and Howard also had to have intense facial surgeries. Despite the surgeries, Howard's cheekbone was beyond repair. Howard's plane accident was not the only one to occur while filming. Al Wilson was flying the Sikorsky S-29A, when he went into a spin. Wilson realized he had no control over the plane. He shouted towards the back to the mechanic Phil Jones to jump out, but Phil was not able to hear Wilson. Phil died instantly when the plane crashed. This incident can be seen in the movie too, but only for a short time. Another two separate plane accidents happened. In one of these stunts, pilot Earl Johnson died, and in the other stunt pilot Clement Phillips died. This movie took 3 years to make and cost $2.8 million, which this movie did not even make that much back after it was released by United Artists in 1930. Some producers do not learn from their mistakes. The General. Directed by Buster Keaton, this silent comedy is based on the Great Locomotive Chase memoirs that were written by William Pitanga in 1889. The movie was altered slightly from the true events that occurred, as the memoir was written from the Union's perspective. To gain a larger audience, they could not keep claiming the Confederates were bad people. When the Nashville, Chattanooga and St. Louis Railway realized that Buster wanted to use the locomotive, which was stored at Chattanooga Union Station, was going to be used for a comedy, they refused Buster the locomotive. Bert Jackson, Buster's location manager, found an area in Oregon that had rail tracks from the period of the Civil War, as well as finding two vintage locomotives within the state that were held at Oregon, Pacific and Eastern State Railway. For the stunt were the bridge collapses, Buster brought in a third locomotive named the Texas. This movie failed as it only made $1.5 million, which was nowhere near the budget that was spent on the production, as a third of the budget was spent in Cottage Grove, Oregon. Buster hired about 1,500 extras from Cottage Grove, as well as bringing in 18 freight cars into Cottage Grove, which contained cannons from the Civil War, houses, laborers, and passenger cars that were rebuilt. Among stagecoaches and wagons, all this hustle and bustle that was needed for the set caused the main line to Cottage Grove to be closed. This was not the only cause for the budget to spiral out of control. Buster had dams built so he could adjust the water's depth. Bridges were also built. The people on the payroll was a total of 3,000, which meant $400 were spent an hour on filming. Not only that, but $25 were often paid to the farmers for each stack of hay that caught fire. This was due to the locomotives being in flames due to them burning wood. The fires caused by the engines also spread to forests too. Another stunt put the budget up, which includes the Texas. While shooting the destruction of the Texas in one shot, the locomotive was beyond any repair, and it became known to be the most expensive scene to be filmed in silent movie history, as it cost $42,000. After the scene was shot, the Texas was placed in a river, where it became a tourist attraction, until the salvagers removed the train from the river during World War II, for it to be scrapped. While filming the General, many accidents occurred too. Buster himself fell unconscious after standing too close to a cannon as it fired. Harry Barnes, who was the assistant director for this production, was hit in the face by a blank cartridge. The film budget was put up once again after Fred Lowry, a train brake, sued the production team for $2,900, as Fred's foot was run over by a locomotive. The final icing on the cake was due to a battle, where a fire occurred while filming. Due to the amount of smoke caused by the fire, the production team had to retreat to Los Angeles to complete the production. Most of the critics seemed unthrilled with the movie too when it was first released. This production forced Buster to lose his independence as a filmmaker, and became restricted by a deal with Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer. The General was entered in the United States public domain in 1954, due to copyright registration not being signed in the 28th year after publishing. After revaluation of this movie, The General was preserved in the United States National Film Registry after being nominated by the Library of Congress in 1989, as the movie was classed as being culturally and historically important. Proves it is best to keep away from icy waters. The Viking. Directed by George Melford, this 1931 movie is also known as Vikings of Icefield and White Thunder. This movie was the very first to use dialogue and sound, by using magnetic wire recording in production. The location of the filming was in Canada. The action scenes were filmed at Grand Banks and Labrador. Varick Frissell, the film producer, was quite adventurous, to where Varick took photographs for the movie in Quidividi. After the movie had been privately shown at Nickel Theatre in 1931, Varick decided that the movie needed extra realistic scenes. So Varick decided himself and the cameraman Alexander Penrod should sail on a sailing ship SS Viking. As Alexander and Varick were capturing the ice floes of Labrador, SS Viking became stuck in the ice near Horse Islands. There was also dynamite on board the SS Viking. While the production crew was trying to get a perfect shot of an iceberg, the dynamite detonated. After the blast, some crew members of SS Viking were able to make it to the shores of Horse Islands, Unfortunately, 25 crew members were not as lucky and they were killed, along with Varick Frissell and Alexander Penrod. This movie is now classed as being one of the worst incidents that has occurred in film history. Maybe some writings are not supposed to be movies. Noah's Ark. Directed by Michael Curtiz, this 1928 silent disaster movie is based on a story told in the Bible. To film the symbolic flood, the production team used 600,000 gallons of water. With this much water, it made things difficult for cast members and extras. Three people drowned in the water. There were also many other serious injuries due to the volume of water, and many suffered broken limbs, to the point that one of the extras had to have his leg amputated. Dolores Costello, who played Miriam, suffered with pneumonia after being in the water. There were at least 35 ambulances that arrived on set to help the injured. A year after this incident, changes were brought in, where film safety regulations were introduced. Thank you for listening. If you like my content, please like and subscribe. To keep up to date with any future videos, press that notification bell or follow me on Twitter @withanet1.